10th, 2011.
And good evening, I'm Juju Chang. Science fiction almost got it right. Face recognition technology has become part of daily life, but except instead of controlling security access to top secret spy facilities, the technology is being used to identify the people in that crazy picture from last weekend's beach party. It's all happening, of course, on Facebook, which has been quietly using face recognition software on every photo you upload. And today, a privacy group filed a complaint against Facebook with a government regulatory agency. Here's Nick Schifrin.
Facebook knows me. It knows my friends. It tracks what I like, where I live. It knows my sisters are Christy and Laura. But now, Facebook also knows, well, my face. Of all its 500 million users, it can recognize my face out of everyone else's. Not just mine. If you're on Facebook, Facebook can recognize your face, too. Here's how. While we've been uploading more than 20 billion photos, Facebook has been making biometric fingerprints of all our mugs. And now, Facebook has a massive collection of our faces, probably the largest collection in the world. Kind of cool. Kind of creepy. Controversial enough that European Union privacy officials have launched an investigation. Here's how it works. That's our intern, Brenna Williams.
I'm going to upload some photos of myself.
She's one of millions of people who's using this feature already. When Brenna uploads photos, Facebook recognizes her and her friends and says, hey, that's you, right? Most of the time, it is, and tagging becomes almost automated. Face recognition technology has been around for a while, mostly used by police. They even scanned people walking into the Super Bowl and caught 19 criminals. The guys at Face.com in Israel showed us how Facebook's technology works. They are the largest facial recognition company online.
So this is Nick.
And once they had my photo, the computer recognized me no matter where I was, every time.
This is awesome to us. We're glad that there is a way to make face recognition work without scaring away people and by providing them the value without the creepy factor.
Yes, it is kind of cool. If you have hundreds, even thousands of unsorted photos, you can upload them, and you've got a searchable online album instantly. iPhoto and others already do that. But here's the difference. On iPhoto, the information stays on your computer. On Facebook, you and 500 million other people tag each other, and that stays online forever.
There's something going on here that we didn't know about and probably didn't agree to. And that does cross the creepy line.
Mark Rotenberg runs a privacy group. Today, it filed a complaint with the Federal Trade Commission that says Facebook uses this technology without considering the risk.
There's so much that happens on Facebook that feels very open and transparent. We can see what we post on our walls. We can see the images in which we're tagged. But when it turns out that behind the curtain, Facebook is building a giant database.
Facebook's critics say the site has changed our privacy settings before and not told us. Facebook did announce the face recognition option in December in a small blog post. But it's up to us to go deep into our settings and opt out of new features rather than opt in. Today, Facebook opted out of talking to us on camera. But it told us nobody has complained and pointed out this only works for your friends and not the larger Facebook community. Critics aren't convinced.
We think Facebook's interest in almost all of these privacy disputes has been to try to encourage people, cajole people, maybe even trick people into disclosing more personal information than they might otherwise choose to disclose.
Which got us at Nightline thinking, could we trick Facebook and upload photos of things that obviously aren't me? Miss Potato Head, Chewbacca, this guy, all now tagged Nick Schifrin. Maybe Facebook won't recognize me now. And I tried one other way to confuse the computer. We sent that photo to the guys at Face.com. And yup, they recognized me even in my cover-up. Which just goes to show that a disguise may fool your friends, but it probably won't fool Facebook. For Nightline, I'm Nick Schifrin in New York.
Nice try. And you too can try out the Nightline Facial Recognition Challenge. Go to the Nightline Facebook page and test your photo against the facial recognition software. And if you see what you like, give us a like. just ahead.